Now, you might be looking to buy a house in this crazy housing market that we're in, and you just keep on losing. You're wondering why. You're getting so stressed out. You're starting to worry. You got deadlines coming up, and you don't even know how to plan for those deadlines. You are getting extremely desperate, and you're just ready to settle for anything. Just please get me something. Do you kind of feel that that might be you? Well, don't worry. I'm with you. I know what you're going through. I've been through it, and I'm going through it every single day. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you some gems as a real estate agent and also someone who personally just bought his own home, and I'm going to tell you exactly what you need to do to not be stressed, to not get worried, and to win the home of your dreams. And if you're a home buyer, this video is going to help you, and if you're a real estate agent, this video is really going to help you. It's time to win some homes in this seller's market and competitive market, so let's get right into it. Now, real quick, before I jump in, I need two things from you. Number one, hit the like button. It's for free and it pumps out this content to other people who are wondering the same things you're wondering, and it's gonna help them out. And number two, link below. I got a new Discord channel that I want you all to join. It's for free. We talk real estate, money, and business daily, and I'm on there. So get on that channel and let's chat. Now, as I share with you these points and these things to win homes, keep in mind there's still a chance that you can lose, but it's a lot slimmer than what you're doing right now, and I can promise you that. I'm on a hot streak for my clients. We're winning deals left and right. We're winning a ton of them versus 20, 30, 40 other offers on the table, and we're still coming out number one, which is why I'm sharing with you exactly what I do as a real estate agent for my clients and also what I did for myself to win the home. Now, I have to admit to you, I've lost a couple of homes, and it's devastating to go to my clients and tell them, hey, you lost the home of your dreams. I've had clients where they put $50,000 over the asking price, I kid you not, and still lose. They waived everything and they planned their future, and they're like, my kid's gonna be here, and my wife's gonna be here, and my husband's gonna be here, and we're gonna have the grandparents here, and they're planning their whole life because they almost guaranteed they're gonna win it, paying $50K over the price, and I have to break the news to them, and it's the worst feeling ever. So there are some losses, but my winning streak right now is pretty hot, and I'm about to share with you what I do. Now, here's what you need to do as a person who's looking to buy a home or as an agent helping someone buy a home, and a quick tip that I can give you before anything. If you don't have a real estate agent in this market, I think you're making a huge mistake. If you're out there just shopping on your own, don't do that. In a seller's market, it gets competitive and dangerous, and you might waive things that you don't know you're waiving and put yourself in a bad position where you can lose your deposits, lose your money, and you don't want that. So get an agent. It has no cost to you. And most importantly, if that agent has experience in a seller's market, they're gonna help you win the home that you're dreaming for. So that being said, number one is you wanna have strong terms on the contract. And when I mean strong, I mean powerful. When you go to the home, make sure that you have that experienced person with you, AKA a real estate agent. For example, myself, I have experience as a real estate agent, but also I began flipping homes. So I know what it costs to remodel a home. I know what it costs to fix foundation. I know what it costs to do plumbing work and HVAC systems and also roofs. I know those costs. So when I walk with my client to the home, they might be concerned for something, and I'll tell them it will cost you this much. I even have the guy that can help you. Therefore, the most important thing is in a strong term is that you waive things that you really wouldn't ordinarily waive, such as inspections on a home. I know your eyes can't see everything. I know that inspections are extremely valuable, but in a seller's market, so many people are putting offers waiving inspection periods, and having that experienced agent or person with you who can give you some comfort, who can have a second eye on the home and on the property, that's a huge advantage, because if you waive the inspection period, you go straight to pending, it gives the seller confidence in your offer. Now, with strong terms, you're talking about a strong purchase price, you're talking about waiving appraisals, you're talking about waiving contingencies that you normally wouldn't. It's the market that you have to play in, but be careful. I know many who are waiving appraisals, full waivers of appraisal, and what that means is if the home is for $300,000 and it actually appraises at $260,000, you got to pay the difference from the $260,000 all the way up to your purchase price, which could have been 320, 330, 340. So you have to be careful. You have to be making sure that you really want to do that and you actually want to spend $50,000, $100,000 more out of your cash just to get that home. There's another option. You can do something called a partial waiver, which you can limit how low the home can appraise at. That's a lot more safer. If the house is for 300K, you can say that you'll waive the appraisal from anything 300K up to your purchase price. That's safer. Now, I know some people who are waiving a free fall of appraisal, meaning that no matter what it appraises at, they're gonna pay the difference cash. And I think that's crazy. But if you're an agent letting your client do that because you've done the comps, you've checked the area, you know it'll appraise, that's a different story, but be careful on the terms you're putting. So remember, strong terms is number one. Comes with the purchase price, comes with the inspection waivers, comes with the appraisal waivers, comes with you asking for no survey and you'll pay it, comes where you don't want a home warranty, you'll just pay it yourself at a later time. Those things will help you win the home, and that's number one. The next one is, this is not even a tip for you as a home buyer, this is a tip for the agents, as I'm personally, as a real estate agent, throwing in some of my commissions to help my clients get a boost. So instead of me getting full commissions, I'm reducing my commissions to make the seller's net higher and also for me to help my client have a higher purchase price. That's something I do for myself because in a market like this, it's very tough to win. I understand my clients have budgets and they can't go higher than that, and I want to help them as much as I can. It's not just about me making money, it's about letting my clients get into a home that they love and making their life easier. So that's something that I do, and it's worked wonders. In fact, what I like to do is call the listing agent and say, hey, I'm going to give X amount from my commissions. You can either take that, you can give it to your client, whatever you want to do, but this is what I'm going to do for my client. Another thing that I love to do is long emails, breaking down the offer. I break down the offer instead of them having to open the offer. I break it down in bulletin points in the email. So simple, so clear. I tell them the price, I tell them the terms, I tell them the details. It gives them ease. And I also tell them my experiences, how I'm going to make sure this closes, and my client's qualifications. They got this degree, they're working in this job, they have a high position, they've been there for 10 years, whatever. Just let the seller's agent feel confident in your offer, your client, and you. Another thing that I love to do is to tell the lender, my lender, to call the listing agent and give them confidence. Tell them, you checked the credit, you checked the income, you checked the DTI, debt to income. You've done all of that to be able to make sure they qualify so the listing agent can relay the message to the seller, the homeowner, and let them know that we are solid. I even tell them, hey, I'm sorry if I'm annoying you. I understand that this market is crazy and I just want to be in front of you so you can know that we are serious. We want to make this happen. Some agents are getting bombarded by other agents like non-stop, so you have to be respectful with it, but understand that you being smart and constantly in their face, they're going to remember your name and they're going to check your offer and they're going to let the owners know. And the last thing is literally love letters is what it's coming down to in this seller's market. Sending a message to the agent saying, my family, they're gonna love this home. They got kids, they got a beautiful family, they got pets, they wanna swim here, they wanna live here, they wanna do things here, they wanna barbecue, they've already made their dreams, they've done all of this. And sending these love letters is going to make that agent feel so scared and embarrassed to come back to you and tell you that you lost. In fact, I have agents who came back to me so embarrassed to tell me that we've lost, but then when they told me that we've lost, they said, we'll put you as priority, as backup, we'll make sure that we take care of you if anything happens, and they still prioritize me over the other agents because I took that extra step. So even if you lose, you're still at an advantage. Remember, in this market, you want to do anything to be at an advantage, no matter what it is. Even if you don't think it'll help, still try it, because whatever you do that the other agent doesn't do puts you ahead, and not just you ahead, puts your client ahead to get them what it is that they want. Now, I know this market, guys, can be stressful, can be time consuming. I mean, I got some gray hairs from this market, but it is what it is. You gotta stay strong. You gotta not give up. You gotta have faith in God, and you have to believe what's written for you is gonna come for you. God is not gonna forget you. So stay strong, stay persistent. Hire the right people with you, have the right team with you, and make sure that you stay motivated because your time's to come, and hopefully this video helped you. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you got any value, hit the like button, and most importantly, I upload 3 times every week. Subscribe so you don't miss out, and I'll see you all later. And don't forget, join the Discord channel. I'd love to talk to you daily. Anyways, guys, thank you. I'm out.